You may have noticed that there is no shortage of VR events where the topic is some variation of the future of storytelling in virtual worlds. When I bring up Second Life in that context, the first question I always get is,
so, whatever happened to Second Life?
Second Life is doing very well, is my standard answer, especially in education. And here is Professor Tuncer Chan to tell us why.
Because you're creating some playful, engaging, and colorful environment.
Tuncer Chan teaches at the English Language Teaching Department at Istanbul University.
The human being needs to be relaxed to learn something. We all know that under stress, we learn nothing.
Second Life facilitates a vibrant exchange of ideas, says Professor Chan, partially because it affords students full agency over their avatars.
They want to reflect their own real characters that's behind their social masks. I had one student whose voice I've never heard in my life, and instantly when we had this comparative education class, he started using all his experience, and he said that this anonymity that Second Life allows, nobody looks at me, I started sharing. If I can put that into scientific terms, the affective filter is down.
Tuncer's colleague Irfan Simsek from the Computer Education and Instructional Technology Department adds one important component to using Second Life successfully in education.
I think it is important to first replicate a real classroom because students will feel secure because it is something they know.
Irfan helps future teachers evaluate digital tools for classroom use. His comparative studies on, among other platforms, Adobe Connect and Second Life have concluded that
if we are using a virtual world, we can feel that we are together in one space, like a real life.
Istanbul University, founded in 1453, serves some 200,000 students. Tuncer and Irfan maintain the virtual version of the campus, which proudly displays several historic landmarks like the gate, the rectory building, and the fire tower, whose virtual version is definitely easier to climb than the physical counterpart.
This is where we're gonna go up this tower.
The views, though, are spectacular.
Now you're seeing the Bosphorus, the beautiful bridge, and then you see part of the Golden Horn as well.
Istanbul is a real big city because the population is around 15 million. We are one of the 10 biggest cities in the world.
We made it! Okay. Next thing, we need to put teleport device here.
In fact, just a teleport away is Erasmus Island, where the 500 foreign European exchange students visiting the school each year can get acquainted with campus life prior to arriving in Turkey.
So we give them information about what they should do before coming, while they're here, during their stay in here, and then we are giving them information about what they need to do after they leave Istanbul. This creates an easy access to the culture.
Gülçin Tasmedia is a beneficiary of the Erasmus program, but traveling the other direction. She's currently living abroad in Bremen, Germany.
Erasmus Island, we get to know each other. We teach a little survival Turkish. I wouldn't have a feeling of being afraid that I will be lost in the university.
But while bridging the gap between cultures is a key component to Second Life's success in education, Gülçin's colleague Sari Kokusuc, who is still in Turkey, points to her favorite feature of this world, the ease with which one can create supplemental visual teaching materials.
English grammar can be very difficult, and we only have these boring books for teaching. But when we use Machinima, the students retain information much better because they become a part of a fantastical story.
And so, Sare and mutual friend Çağlar Padlar collaborate on actual storytelling in virtual worlds with Gülçin in Germany.
We build the movie set and we play the story together with students, and then we edit the movie.
Machinima is the technical term for films made using game engines, and under the guidance of Professors Irfan Simsek and Tuncer Chan, dozens of such videos have been produced.
The individuals can create materials which suit their own contexts. This empowerment of the teacher is, I think, superior to all other materials.
In their quest for the most effective digital teaching tool, Tuncer and Irfan have also tinkered with Second Life's built-in scripting engine.
We made a proof of concept to teach 7th grade geometry. The robot will give you a feedback, then creates confidence even in kids who say they don't like math.
We use the constructivist approach here, where the students can actually link fractions to real things in life. Like, for example, everybody knows that you need to have a strongest dog in the front. And if you can do it right, then you get onto the sleigh and then it moves.
We also made a game where you have to find out what crops grow in which part of the country and what the weather conditions have to be like in different climatic zones of Turkey. If you are correct, you see the result change in real time.
As inspiring as all these projects are, I do wonder, will Second Life continue to matter in education in a time of unprecedented technological progress? Most certainly, says Tuncer Can.
Second Life works because it combines lots of things like training, practice, reflection, and collaboration. VR may be able to do that someday, but currently it's too expensive and we can't just buy 50 headsets for students.
And what does Irfan Simsek get out of Second Life besides the positive feedback from thousands of graduating students?
One time at graduation, the mother of my student who I have never seen before says, I know you on Second Life.
Well, there you have it. For the Drax Files World Maker series, slightly jealous that Irfan has obviously surpassed me in virtual celebrity status, I'm Draxtor Dupre.
Lilo, I'm a celebrity in Second Life.
Je suis célèbre dans Second Life.